Happy birthday, Rachel.
Happy birthday, Rachel. Say happy birthday. Say happy birthday. He said it. He did it. He said happy birthday. Happy birthday, Rachel!
John Watson has made you some cake.
Happy birthday, Rachel. How does it feel to be 15? I know when I turned 15, I felt exactly the same, but it might be different for you. I don't know. Let me know. Anyways, so, yeah. Today, in case you didn't get it, is Rachel's 15th birthday. Yay! She survived. I'm just kidding. Life's not that hard. I mean, it is, but let's not get deep now.
Happy birthday! So today we are doing a video to just celebrate you and your birthday today, and we have a few questions that Andrea came up with.
First thing that we're going to talk about is our favorite memory with Rachel. And I think one of my favorite memories with Rachel is just doing theater with her. We did a lot of theater together. That's how we met. We met through theater. And having play practices and musical practices. And I think having her at my 16th birthday party was really fun. I think one of my favorite memories that's pretty recent is we were going, because Burr and her are in the same play right now, are in the same musical together. We went to go pick up Burr from play practice because he was gonna come over. Oh, and Nolan. And so we came in like a half an hour to an hour before their practice was supposed to end. And we just were in there and Rachel wasn't doing anything and Burr wasn't doing anything. So we all just kind of hung out and sat at the piano and talked and chatted, and it was just, it's a really simple memory, but it was a lot of fun and I really enjoyed it.
So it was past summer, and I went to your house because our moms were like, oh hey, these two girls, they should be friends because they have the same personality type. So that's kind of how it happened, and I ended up at your house. I wanted to be there, trust me, I did. I was just like, this is a little bit different. I've never been to your house before, but I had a lot of fun. I remember hanging out in your room and you tried to explain the Avengers to me and I was like, I can't really grasp this because it's a very complicated subject, as most people know. And we listened to like a lot of music or something, and I don't even know what we listened to. I think it was like classical music, but you just had like your CD player going and we were just like talking and looking at your room and your posters and stuff. And we went outside like later on and we sat on your trampoline and we bounced a little bit on it and talked about a lot of stuff. We get along very well, and I think our moms are right that
we've known each other for almost 3 years now. I remember we met at basketball camp and you were playing defense against me. But we didn't really start to get to know each other until about a year and a half ago in the play Young Jane Eyre, when you were Jane's nurse Bessie and I was Miss Miller, the school teacher. We would hang out backstage and that was really fun. And I remember you had the most fantastic British accent. And then I got to light you up as the housekeeper in Oliver, and you sang so beautifully to little Oliver, and that was such a sweet scene. But I have to say my favorite memory of you is probably the same one that you gave me in my video, Doctor Who cosplay when you were Gender Bent 9. So much fun. We went out to this shed by Laura's and you found this old cupboard and you found a Stetson in it, or nearby or something. Like it was a hat that was similar to a Stetson, and you had this banana gun and you were just being so hilarious with your unique sense of humor, and you were talking in a British accent the whole time, and you were just the best Gender Bent 9 ever.
My favorite memories with Rachel are probably kind of like what I said with Andrea. I mean, not exactly, because we're different people. Being in plays with Rachel have been so much fun. No, just like hanging out. Like, every memory is a favorite memory with Rachel. Like, just a couple weeks ago, like last month, we were, like, walking around the mall, like, Target, for fun. And that was fun. Like, waiting for moms, and just sitting and joking, just hanging out, or just sitting and drawing. This is gonna tie in with another question, but, one time, me, Rachel, and Laura were supposed to be paying attention during Bible study, and I mean, technically it wasn't our time, it was like the younger kids, but we were sitting and drawing and listening to music, and Rachel drew that. Like, I mean, how amazing is that? That actually, like, looks like me. And the reason Laura has sunglasses on is because apparently her eyes got messed up, but anyways, better than I could ever hope to do in my lifetime. That's probably one of my favorite memories, just sitting and drawing together, or just her always having something funny to say. It was always, she's just always, half the time, whenever you talk, Rachel, I'm just like, where does she come up with this to say? Just because you are so funny that I'm just like, my tiny brain doesn't work like that. I don't know. You're just funny. That's what I'm trying to get off my chest here.
Writing with you is a really good memory of mine, even though we're like still doing it. It's not like a past thing. It's kind of like a continuing thing. But you helped me create character to go along with my initiates that I was creating with my friends for my book. And we both kind of collaborated on this little fan fiction, you know, for your character Swan. And it was really fun doing that. Like, I really enjoyed that, and we should, like, try to revive that. But we each wrote a little bit and sent it back and forth doing emails, and that was fun. And we were inspired by the Sherlock special, yes. You wrote a fan fiction of the scene with Sherlock and Moriarty, and that was really fun for me to do that with you, because I was like, oh my gosh, this is going to be so much fun to act out, because we were planning on, like, filming the scene later, and I, like, cannot wait to do that, because I really want to do that still, and I guess we kind of ran into a rut or something, so we're going to, like, start over. Yeah, I need to get to you on that. Don't let me forget. Come to me later or something. But that was very fun.
Another favorite memory would be from my birthday video, when you told me that I was kind of like the big sister that you never had. That was really sweet, and that really meant a lot to me, especially since we haven't spent a ton of time together, and yet you still thought that. So that was just really sweet. Thank you.
What is something that reminds you of Rachel? So, I guess the first thing that comes to mind is Sherlock. Sherlock reminds me of you, okay? I guess after determining that you are Sherlock and I am Moriarty, I've always, like, envisioned you acting out Sherlock's part and being him. Whenever I see, like, episodes, I always, like, picture you playing the part. Probably because you're the only person that I know who could do that so well, because you were pretty much Sherlock in real life, as well as me being Moriarty, but we're not going there, we're talking about you. At Bible study the other day, or it was like a week ago, you were playing on the piano, kind of like, not really playing it, but you know, kind of like fiddling with it, and I came up to you and I was like, so, are you pretending to be Sherlock, only you have a piano? And you're like, maybe? And that's just like another reason why I think that, well, Sherlock reminds me of you, because you guys are kind of same-ish. Shakespeare also reminds me of you, because whenever I see you, you're always reading something written by Shakespeare or some sort of adaptation or thing, and also talking about him or quoting something from him.
I think something that reminds me of Rachel is like old literature, Jane Austen books. I think what comes to mind when I think of Rachel is like new classic. Does that make sense? Like, she takes like classic elements and like brings it to herself, but makes it like not necessarily new, but it's like classic things in a new era. Do you know what I mean, Edward?
Sure.
Birthday video featuring Edward.
Old beautiful things.
Old beautiful things. Like old school teacups from like a Victorian era. Or like porcelain dolls that are really like classy and beautiful, and like they're so detailed with their like the way they're painted and crafted and beautiful things. That's what reminds Edward and I of Rachel.
Something that reminds me of you, Rachel, would probably have to be your fandoms, especially the ones that I don't know a lot about, like Star Wars and Avengers. I associate those with you, and if I see a pin, I'm like, oh, I bet Rachel would like that. And British humor, definitely British humor. It's very you. And classics like Shakespeare and Northanger Abbey. I remember you would talk about that at backstage at Oliver, and I haven't read that one yet, so that one always just kind of makes me think of you like, oh, I should read that. I bet Rachel would like that if I read it.
Something that reminds me of you. I don't know, that's kind of like a hard question just because, like, you remind me of you, and, like, I guess whenever I see something funny, I think of you just because you are so hilarious. You always brighten my day with whatever you say because you're just so funny. Whenever I see something Star Wars or Sherlock, I think of you, because I know it's something that you like, and I like it too.
And last but not least, the final question. What is one thing you think Rachel is very skilled at?
This is a hard thing for us all, but keeping a straight face or composure, like a very elegant and relaxed composure during like odd or tough situations, like when there's something funny but it's like not really funny, or when there's other people doing weird things, or just like weird situations, okay? You always seem to have like this straight composure, like elegance, like I'm a lady, I'm all composed and kept together, and it makes you look really responsible and mature, which is like a lot like Sherlock, because he's always like really stiff and stuff, but you know, he's a child at heart. Really cool how you can keep a straight face and act like so mature, but also be like have child spirit and be like Sherlock.
It sounds weird, but as a person who spends an ungodly amount of time on the internet, you kind of notice, you know, who can do a good video content. She makes good content.
She does make. See, I like her content too.
I think she should do her own thing on her channel. You need to do that.
Edward thinks you should do stuff on your own channel. And I agree, you make very good YouTube content. Because, as he said, it's not blathering. Like, I blather.
Not blathering, but it's intelligent.
It is. You're really good at art, you're really good at acting. I can't pick one thing, Andrea! You're good at art, you're good at acting, and you're good at vlogging. You're skilled in those things, and it's impressive, and it's great. And I think especially since we're people that are trying to become skilled at vlogging and at video making and at entertaining, you have that natural ability, as Edward said, to be informative and to be something interesting. Whereas, you know, that's something that I have to work on and I have to work at, is to not blather and not babble on about random things. And you know, you're good at just sitting down and talking about three things and doing those three things. And it being informative or whatever, it doesn't have to be through English.
You're very skilled at acting and singing and at writing, even though I haven't read a ton of your writing, but I would love to read more. You also, you pursue knowledge. I love that you read classics and don't shy away from big, fat, thick, old books that some people might think would be too intimidating, but you tackle them, and I admire that because I wish I was more like that.
Something that you're skilled at. Let me get out my list. You have so many abilities I could never dream to have, like I showed you. I mean, this is just one of her many things that she's done, and like, or she made me this Valentine's Day card last Valentine's Day, and it's just so, I love everything about it, like the fact that it's on a just random piece of paper, and it just has a bunch of random blurry stuff. Like, this is the best card I've ever gotten in my life. Like, I feel like lots of my cards I will just like stuff in a drawer or something, but this card I keep out like on my dresser all the time, just because whenever I look at it, it makes me feel happy, just because it reminds reminds me of you. There, this reminds me of you because you made it. You gave it to me, obviously. But just, I just love it so much. And I feel like it's the most thoughtful thing anyone's ever really given me. Even though it may not have seemed like something like that for you. Like, I mean, something like a little thing like that. Just, yeah. You're very skilled at being funny. Like I've said a billion times in this. I mean, hello, everybody already knows that. Just watch her videos.
That is Rachel. Rachel's a great person. So to wrap up this video, I just want to wish you a happy birthday, my dear, beautiful, wonderful Rachel, with your fabulous curly hair.
I'm really excited that you are turning 15. I can't believe we're all getting so old, and it's kind of scary, but congratulations on being 15. You're 1 year closer to being 16. It's gonna be scary, like when you're driving a car or something. Like, I'm gonna start freaking out because all my friends are gonna be driving, and I'm just like,
I hope you have an amazing birthday. I am so happy for you for having a birthday. I just think birthdays are great.
Happy birthday once again.
Happy birthday. I hope you have an amazing, beautiful day, and that 15 will be an amazing year, and you'll have a ton of awesome adventures and new books to read and things to discover and cases to solve. I'm really glad to know you. You're a great person and a great friend, and I hope to get to know you better too.
Happy birthday. I will see you soon. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Rachel. Happy birthday to you. Bye.
Okay, well, I'll see you later.
Happy birthday. We love you very much. I love you very much. And it's fun to have someone that I can relate to as much as I can relate to you. And thanks for being my friend. And I hope that you come back to the channel soon because we really miss you. We miss you a lot, so please come back soon. Please.
It was an honor to make this video for you. I really, really hope you enjoy it. So happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Okay.
Bye.
Hugs, hugs.
Goodbye.